can't believe I'm doing this. This is despicable.
Hello, Jonathan. Please, come in.
At least you survived the Great War. I feared the worst.
What do you need from me, Jonathan?
Do you need my medical attention?
No thanks, Jonathan.
Goodbye for now.
I remember when Mary came here with her husband and her son. They were such a beautiful family.
It could be someone you know, even someone you're close to.
Good evening, old chap. Are you all right?
I won't lie to you, Johnny. I'm not a well man.
How is your wife, Venus?
We've spent so much time away from each other, and so many things have happened.
Is everything all right at home? Surely Venus was relieved to see you returned from France in one piece.
Have you forgot what people are like in this part of town, Johnny? Venus fears for our family reputation. Now her husband has become the village idiot.
But you're alive. You returned in one piece and you have a family. How many soldiers can say the same?
Believe me, it's not quite that simple. Like you, I'm not the man I used to be.
You need some rest, Clarence. You should try to sleep. Good evening, Miss Ashbury.
And good evening to you, Dr. Reed.
I have found out what happened to your friend, Emily.
I can handle the truth. There's no need to hide the bloody details.
Your friend was planning to become a vampire. She thought she'd met an honest one and made a deal with him. Unfortunately, Emily did not survive the process.
My mother told me many times about the risks of being turned. I often suspected she exaggerated the danger to avoid me being tempted.
No, the risk is real. Have you any idea what a body has to endure to become an organism entirely consumed by its need to process and recombine blood?
I should never have talked to Emily about vampires. I never thought she'd actually try it without me. Thank you, sir. Here, take this for your discretion.
Do you need my medical attention, Charlotte?
I am fine, Dr. Reed.
Goodbye, Charlotte. Give my best regards to your mother when you see her.
She's been quite busy these last few nights. I suspect you may see her before me.
to vote is only the first step.
I'm hungry. Where shall I eat?
Women die too in this war.
fresh warm blood. Where are you? Yes, eternal life, fresh warm blood.
You give me no other choice, Clarence. Yes, my love, it's a new tea I bought. Not too bitter for your taste, I hope. Drink your tea, my love. Drink it to the last drop. And shut your damn trap for good.
Hello, Venus.
Hello, Jonathan. Please, come in.
You know that you are always welcome here, but at this hour of night?
What do you need from me, Jonathan?
Why are you poisoning your husband?
He has spent a fortune printing his bloody papers. I can't stand this nightmare anymore. We are the butt of everyone's joke since he returned.
If you're so frustrated by Clarence's behavior, why don't you just leave him?
I have already lost the best years of my life because of him. I will not jeopardize my future for some lunatic. He goes, and I inherit what's left.
I was the best man at your wedding. I remember your love for him. It was so beautiful. I cried. And now you've killed him.
Don't try to send a shiver down my spine, Dr. Reed. You were always on your own, and you kept emotions at bay. All for facts, remember? Well, deal with this one.
Why are you poisoning your husband?
He has spent a fortune...
If you're so frustrated by Clarence's behavior, why don't you just leave him?
I have already lost the best years of my life because of him. I will not jeopardize my future for some lunatic.
I was the best man at your wedding. I remember your love for him. It was so beautiful. I cried. And now you've killed him.
Don't try to send a shiver down my spine, Dr. Reed. You were always on your own, and you kept emotions at bay. All for facts, remember? Well, deal with this one.
Goodbye for now.
I'm so sorry for your loss, Jonathan.
They're all around you, waiting for you to let your guard down.
Good evening, old chap. Are you all right?
I won't lie to you, Johnny. I'm not a well man.
Venus is poisoning you, Clarence. She wants you dead.
So she really hates me that much now? My poor wife. I had no idea my research would drive her to such extremes.
I'm sorry, Clarence.
Why would you tell me that? First you returned from the dead, and now you tell me my wife is trying to murder me.
You're a stupid bastard, but you're my friend, Clarence. And I don't have many left. I don't want you to die. Not like that.
But I love her. I love my wife. Did I make her suffer that much? Have I become such a burden?
So you have no suspicions about her at all? Nothing in Venus's behavior has seemed odd since you returned.
Frankly, it's my behavior that's been odd. Ever since I got back from the war, she accuses me of being paranoid and delusional.
You need some rest, Clarence. You should try to sleep. Hello, Venus.
Hello, Jonathan. Please, come in.
I'm so sorry for your loss, Jonathan.
What do you need from me, Jonathan?
Why do you and your husband argue so much?
He is not the kind man I married and loved. He is obsessed now. Obsessed with chimeras. I feel trapped. It just makes me want to scream.
Goodbye for now.
At least you survived the Great War. I feared the worst.
Good evening, old chap. Are you all right?
I won't lie to you, Johnny. I'm not a well man.
Venus is poisoning you, Clarence. She wants you dead.
So she really hates me that much now? My poor wife. I had no idea my research would drive her to such extremes.
I'm sorry, Clarence.
Why would you tell me that? First you return from the dead, and now you tell me my wife is trying to murder me.
You need some rest, Clarence. You should try to sleep.
Whether you need to buy something or not, I'm happy to help.
Are you deaf?
Oh!
stupid thing! You cannot win this!
I'm Dr. Jonathan Reed. Do you need help, sir?
I think I'm fine. But what happened to my jailer? Be careful. He's as vicious as he is strong.
You don't have to worry about him anymore. What happened here?
I am Tadao Kimura. I was imprisoned by this lunatic for several days. I thought I was going to die here.
You're not going to die now, Mr. Kimura. If you hurry, you should be able to get home safely.
It seems that I owe you my life. You have all my gratitude, Dr. Reed, since it is the most precious thing I possess.
Goodbye, Mr. Kimura. Take care. Are you sure you'll manage to reach the West End by yourself, Mr. Kimura?
Yes, I'm perfectly capable of defending myself when not ambushed by insane cultists.
Goodbye, Mr. Kimura. Take care.